Welcome to the Introduction to Creating Quick Display Containers and Buttons in Display Studio. This tutorial explains the functionality and demonstrates how to create a Quick Display Container and Button. Quick Display Containers provide a simple and intuitive way to show a playlist of content on a system with a single display. To create a new container, right-click in the gray area of a workspace page, hover over New, and choose Quick Display Container. Select the zone from the drop-down list to play the content to. It's important to remember that Quick Display Containers can only play content to a single zone per container. If you need a button that controls multiple displays or zones in your system, a scripting container may be a better method. After choosing the Display Zone, the remaining settings set the default parameters for the container. The visible thumbnail box reveals a thumbnail image for each button in the container. Selecting Immediate Play will immediately start the content when clicked, rather than having the content be added to the end of the queue. The Clear Queue on Play option will select the Immediate Play option. This will add the file from the button you selected to the top of the queue and clear the other remaining files in the queue. The Play Mode options select the default playback mode for buttons created in this container. Options include having the content play continuously or play a set number of times. Some systems may include the ability to play only a selected frame and play in a single step mode. The Pause mode has a few selections in the dropdown. Pause on first frame, pause on last frame, pause on first and last frame, and as of version 2.20, pause on the first frame within the first file of the playlist, pause on the last frame within the last file of the playlist, and pause on the first and last frame of the playlist are available. When finished, click Save. To expand the container to fill the page, click the white rectangle in the top right corner of the container. There are two different methods for creating a button. The first method links a container to a library or folder of content files. This method allows for quick creation of multiple buttons. In the Quick Display Container Properties screen, choose Link to Library. A window will appear with a list of all library folders within the content folder. Choose the library you wish to link to the container to, and then choose Open. The Link to Library button will then change to Unlink from Library, and the library name will appear next to the button. Click Save. Any piece of content already in this library or added to it will now have a button automatically created for it within this container. The second method is to create quick display buttons individually. Right-click in the container and select New Button to open the button creation window. Once open, select Add to open the file browser window and select the file or files you want the button to play. The first icon is a folder. This is the file selection icon for inserting or adding a file or files to a quick display button. The second icon is a stacked set of images and controls the behavior of the playlist. Normal playlist means all files will be added to the queue in the order that they are listed in the button. Shuffle playlist means all files will be added to the queue in a shuffled order. Next playlist means files will be added into the queue one at a time, and clicking the button again will add the next file in the playlist to the queue. A random playlist means files will be added to the queue one at a time in a random order. The third icon is a clapboard. This is the playlist mode icon, and it sets the file or files to be continuous or to run a certain number of times. The fourth icon is a pause icon. This allows you to set the pause mode for the item. Pause on first frame, pause on last frame, pause on first and last frame. As of version 2.20, playlist pause on first, playlist pause on last, and playlist pause on first and last are available. The fifth icon is a circular arrow, and it sets the runtime for the selected content. Here, you can set the duration of the content or the repeat count of the content. The sixth icon is an arrow, which allows you to set an entry transition to the selected content. Select a transition type from the drop-down list, along with a transition time. Some transitions also reveal a transition direction option. The seventh icon is for audio control. This offers settings for adjusting the volume of the file, along with the ability to disable embedded audio or choose an alternate file for sound to play along with a graphic or clip. The eighth icon represents the Mark In, Mark Out feature. On any motion graphic, you can set a custom start and endpoint for the animation or video file by grabbing the endpoints of the scrub bar and moving them in or out. The ninth and final icon is a thumbnail. Here, you can choose the scrub bar to determine which portion of the motion graphic to use as the button's thumbnail. This may also be done from the thumbnail icon in the top right of the button located next to the color palette icon. For stills, scrub bar will be grayed out. When these settings are complete, continue with naming the button and selecting a button color if desired. Click Save. The display cue can be shown or hidden by clicking the letter Q on the right side of the container. This provides a visual list of the items in the file queue, as well as playback information and controls. Any content that is currently playing will appear in the queue list. The controls are located at the bottom and allows quick access to commonly used functions for managing the queue. Next, which plays the next item in the queue. Pause, which pauses playback of the queue. Stop, which stops the queue. Blank sign, which stops playback of the queue, blanks the display, and clears the queue. Clear queue, which clears the queue but allows the current item to keep playing. And finally, loop, which when enabled will play through items in a queue continuously until stopped or given another command. This concludes the tutorial for creating quick display containers and buttons. Continue to other videos to learn more about your Daktronics control system.